term insight, the great saint Kabir told, "Bahar ke pat band kar, andar ke pat khol." So try to close your external door and open internal door. Be aware inside. Be calm and quiet. Relax your body. Relax your mind. Be aware about your inner self. Visualize endless space full with divine energy. Visualize globe in the space and your body on the globe in the space too. It means you are sitting on the globe in the space. Visualize it. This is your real position. This is not only speculation, but be aware about this truth. Now, visualize ocean of energy in the space. Energy is flooding surrounding your body, and same energy is entering into your body through your nostrils in the form of breath and giving you life. We are alive due to that breath, that energy. Okay? So pay our attention on the breath. Be aware, infinite source of energy. Only beyond your nostrils, you will see ocean of energy. And same energy is your source of life. It means you are part and partial of infinity. When you will pay your attention on the source of life, you will realize unity in diversity, because all beings are receiving life energy from one source. It means source of life is one. Okay, be aware about it. Then you will be able to realize oneness in all. Be calm and quiet and serene. Veda declare that one supreme cause is residing in each heart. It means we all are only part and partial of one supreme infinity. Be aware about it and think aware about it. This is a process of meditation. You pay your attention to your breath, realize infinite source of breath. If you have any mantra, you can chant with your breath. Your mind, sound and breath should be one. Only 2 minutes. Now, you should recite 3 times pranava with me, create long sound, holy sound, very pious son. You think you are elevating your consciousness from lower to high with this song.
These all great countries were. But
you'll find millions of years old Bharat still now. Why? What is the cause? Be aware about it. Some cause is that must be immortal. Due to that, we survive ourselves from those great disasters which swept out all those ancient nations and countries. Still, we are alive. You know very well, 700 continuous Muslim invaded on India. 700. They ruled some part of India too. And 200 continuous European people, not only one, England, France, Portuguese, Dutch and German. These five countries invaded India, they looted a lot. And they destroyed a lot too. But still, we are alive. What is the immortal cause behind it? You know, that is our only Sanatana Dharma. Vedic Dharma. Because Sanatana Dharma was not established by a person. Nobody knows that when this Dharma was started and by whom this Dharma was started. Nobody knows. I can say surely, because I am master of history too, ancient history. I searched a lot, but I didn't find any evidence that who was establisher of this Sanatana Dharma. But I got perfect message about it from our Vedas. The great seers, those who are living in a higher level of consciousness, those who are one with Supreme Cause, they realize that ultimate truth. They declare in Veda, Veda hametam purusham mahantam aditya varnam tamasah parastar tame viditva atimrtveti dhanya pantha vidyate ayanaya. The hymns in Veda, Yajur Veda, and they declare that I know that Supreme Cause that is beyond this darkness, beyond this energy, beyond this nature, and effulgent of life. And really, they declare, tamaya viditva atimrtveti. If you will know that Supreme Cause, you will cross sphere of death. And you will achieve immortality. Nanyah pantha vidyate anaya. There is no other way to be immortal on this mortal world. So, I would like to say you that those great seers who are in the beginning of this world, in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna stated, Marsaya Saptapurve Chattvaro Manvastatha Madhava Manasa Jata Esham Lok Ima Praja. All humanity, not only Indian, all humankind are children of those great seers and great Manus too. Really, our great seers declared that divine supreme consciousness is our father and this divine mother earth is our mother. Mata Bhumi Putroham Prithibhyam Devahu Pitasahanapi Partu. This earth is my mother and Supreme Lord is my father. We are children of this divine parents. They declare in Veda. It means when this hymns was written, at those days there were no so many kinds of nation on the earth. There were not so many kinds of nations, so many kinds of religions, so many kinds of sects, and whatever we are seeing now in different name and form. These all diversity was not existing at those days when these Vedas were written. It means this eternal knowledge sought by great seers and was established by those seers for humankind, not only for Hindus. Due to that, this is not Hindu dharma, this is Sanatan dharma. Why then we are calling Hindu dharma? Because when some different sects came in India, okay? Different sects came in India from outside and they started to teach their own sectarian ideology and fanaticism related by one person and one guru, you can say, or you can say prophet, you can say messiah, whatever you like you can say. And at that time, our people started to say Hindu dharma. Hindu word was related with our country, in our countrymen too. Okay? Himalayam samarambha yavad Hindu sarovaram. Be aware who is Hindu and what Hindu is. Himalayam samarambha yavad Hindu sarovaram tad deva nirmitam kshetram hindusthanam prachakshate. In holy scriptures we are reading, from Himalaya this one word was taken by great seer, he, okay? And Hindu sarovara means Kanyakumari, Cape Kumari. That is called Hindu sarovara, okay? So Hindu sarovara was Hindu and he was taken from Himalaya. So that became Hindu, Hindusthanam, where from Himalaya to Hindu sarovara, this pious land was declared as a Hindustan. Tad deva nirmitam desham Hindustanam prachakshate. And those people who are living in this place, divine place, they were called Hindu. And that culture, that ideology, that way of life, which was, you know, sprung from that divine place, were called Hindu culture, Hindu dharma, and Hindu civilization. So my dear, be aware, this Sanatan dharma is the eternal dharma, and this is not only for those people who are living in India, but for all mankind, all humankind. Due to that, I am spreading this ideology, you know, very well, since 23 years in these countries. Okay? In European countries, first I came, and after that I came here. And I visited so many countries in the world, and where there I went, people welcomed this ideology, because I love people, I love humankind. There is no discrimination. Either these human beings are born from east or west, there is no discrimination. I always declare that as sun is one, moon is one, earth is one, wind is one, space is one, and all source of life is one, then how dharma will be so many? Because dharma is the base of life. Okay? We all are living in same nature. We all are children of same nature. We all are children of same spirit. So there is no division in divine sphere. Division was created by human mind. And we should try to remove this division and try to accept reality. What reality is, we should try to know that and try to be aware about that. You know, if you read history of great Bharata, you can say India, never mind. If you read history of great India, and you find out that when India was greatest nation, was accepted as a guru of all world and richest country in the world too. If you have any doubt, then I will recommend you some books. You can read and you will find out what India was. Okay? Those Chinese travelers who came in India spent so many years as a Hyun Sang, Fai An, all. And that was one, you know, ambassador from Yunnan. His name was Megasthenes. He was living in the court of Chandragupta. And he wrote, what your summary about India, if you read those books, then you will understand what India was. And I'm not talking about in Treta, in Dwapara, I'm talking about in Kaljuga too. When India was so great country, and so powerful country, so richest country, and people were thinking that India is the abode of knowledge, abode of culture, abode of civilization, abode of philosophy, and not only philosophy, abode of science too. You know, root of science is mathematics, many kinds of mathematics. And all kinds of mathematics was born from India. There was a great mathematician, his name was Pythagoras from Yunnan. He was a disciple of India. And you can read his life history, you will find out it. So I was telling, all kinds of knowledge may be related with worldly affairs, may be related with spiritual knowledge, may be related with divine power. All kinds of knowledge was searched by great seers in India. Okay? Nowadays, Veda is the abode of knowledge. Veda is the abode of knowledge. And nobody, not only Veda, but so many other shastras too. And many kinds of philosophy. And you will surprise. In India, there were believers of God, in God. And you find there were not only theist people, but atheist people also had same respect in our country. You know, all Vedic philosophers were believing in Godhead. But there was Lord Buddha. We accept him as the incarnation of Lord Vishnu. He was not believing in God. He declared there is no God. And no need to think about God, no need to talk about God. When a person was asking about God, he always was saying, no, it is your not correct question. Don't talk about whatever is unknown place. Okay? So, you know that Bodhisattva, Jaini, there was Mahavira, he didn't talk about God too, and to our Charyavakya, and there are so many other philosophers. We accepted them, we honor them. Why? That is the place of free thought, that is place for free way of worship, that is the place of humankind, because we know that never time will come when all human beings will achieve same state of mind. And same state of intellect, same state of consciousness. We know that never time will come when all people will achieve same level of consciousness. No, it is impossible. So diversity is the beauty of nature. What do you think? Diversity is the beauty of nature. Due to that, we Sanatana Dharmi always accept diversity. And we believe that every person can think according to his own state of mind and can speculate, can imaginate, and can worship. There is no fanaticism in Sanatana Dharma. You know, there is Vedanta philosophy who declared that whole universe is nothing but projection of one supreme cause, that is Brahma, Sarvam Khalidam Brahma. And there is a materialistic ideology too. And declared by Brihaspati, that's called Lokayata Mata. Okay? And we respect Brihaspati and we respect Vyasadeva too. Why? Because we believe unity in diversity.
We believe unity in diversity. We know that this diversity is nothing but projection of unity. In any way, if you adopt any path, one day you will reach on same destination. There is no doubt, not today but tomorrow. Due to that, my dear, this Sanatan Dharma has great ideas and great literatures, and you will surprise. There are abode of knowledge in Sanskrit language. And if you go in London, and there is a British Museum library, you will go there and you will want to see, then you will surprise that not only one and two, so many stories are filled with Sanskrit literature in that British Museum. And very old literature those British people brought from India, they are still there. So I was telling you that Sanatan Dharma was not established by a person. This is the search of great seers, and this not only for one nation, for one group, for one, you know, class and creed and color and country and community. This is for humankind. Due to that, I think that whole India are situated by that divine essence. Okay? That's called Sanatan Dharma. Internally, externally, you will see diversity there. Because I visited whole India many times, from east to west and south to north. Okay? And I have seen same ideology in different form, different language, and different color. This is the beauty. And I wish that this place should be representative of real India. Maybe Gujarati, maybe Hindi, maybe Punjabi, maybe Bengali, maybe Madrasi, maybe any, you know, part of India, and they were speaking in any language in India, they are adopting any part of India, but this place should be center of India. And Indian culture, people come and see here, and I think that this place should be abode of Vedic ideology. From Veda to Hanuman Chalisa, you know, every part of India I have seen, people believe in Veda. In every part of India I have seen, people believe in Hanuman Chalisa too. From Veda to Hanuman Chalisa should be taught here. And this place should be abode of Indian culture, Indian art, Indian civilization, and Indian dharma, Sanatan Dharma. Be aware. Those who are follower of different other sects, there are so many sects in India, I never mind. Because in our tradition, if any sect is new or started by one person, if he is telling something according to Veda, then we accept as a part of Sanatan Dharma. If he is talking against Veda, then we think, okay, he is not part of Sanatan Dharma, but he is twisting his own way of thinking. So not today, but tomorrow, when he will try to search truth, then he will reach on that destination. Don't worry about it. So I always welcome all people and all, you know, believers. Either you are believing in God, or you are believing in your own self, or you are believing in material ideology, in any way. But you must open your mind. But you open your mind and you try to listen all and try to think about all. If you will open your mind, if you will open your heart, then you will find out what reality is and what truth is. I believe that my dear disciples, those who are working here very hard, they work hard, they are working and they are ready to work. Okay? Yesterday when I came here, one my disciple told, Guruji, you must believe in our disciples, your children. By your own little indication, we will